Hi guys, welcome back to the fourth video of Google Tag Manager course. In previous videos, we learned how to install Google Tag Manager in Shopify. On second video, we learned how to set up Google Analytics 4 on Shopify using Google Tag Manager. On third video, we created a Google Ads campaign. And now in fourth video, we'll set up a Google Ads conversion tracking tag using Google Tag Manager. If you are new to this, I recommend you guys watch the previous videos. I'll put the link in the description below so it will be easy for you guys. Now, let's jump into the screen. So guys, this is a smart Google AdWords campaign which we created on our last video. And this is the Google Tag Manager container which we created on our first video. So again, if you haven't watched the previous videos, I'll put the link in the description below. So for now, for this video, we'll set up a Google Ads conversion tracking. Now let's click on settings and switch to expert mode. So guys, that's how expert mode will look like. And from expert mode, click on tools again and click on measurement. And from here, click on conversions. Setting up a conversion action, meaning that Google AdWords will be able to understand that how many leads or how many signups we are getting from each campaign. And that way, the automated system of Google will improve the campaign further to get more conversion, get more signups for your campaign. Now let's set up a purchase conversion action. These are all the default conversion actions which Google AdWords set on their own. We will create a custom conversion action because we want to track the purchases on our Shopify store. And let me also open up our development store. Now let's set up a conversion action. Click on website. And here we will select purchase, or we can also select begin checkout or add to cart if you want to track. For now, I'll select purchase because we will be tracking purchase. Conversion name purchase, let it be. And don't use a default value for this conversion action recommended. On count, select every, because we want to count every single conversion. And everything is fine here, but on attribution model, make sure to select position based, because that's what is recommended by Google. And we'll also discuss attribution model in detail in upcoming videos. So for now, just click create and continue. And from there, click on use Google Tag Manager. And now we have our conversion ID and conversion label. Now we will go to Google Tag Manager and create a new tag for our AdWords conversion. Click on tag configuration and from here select on Google Ads conversion tracking. And once you do that, you'll see that it's showing us a prompt where we need to create a conversion linker. So conversion linker is a global tag for Google AdWords where conversion linker will tell Google that this specific traffic is coming through Google Ads, not from Google Organic or any other source of traffic. So click on create, type in conversion linker. And hit save. Here we go. Our conversion linker tag has been created now. Now add in your conversion ID from Google Ads. Copy it, paste it here. Add in conversion label. Copy and paste. And now we want this conversion tag to trigger only when someone purchases the product. So in last video, we already set up the purchasing custom event, custom trigger. And we'll just select that. So here we have purchase page trigger, which we will click and hit on save. There we go. Now click on submit. I'll name this version to a setup of conversion tracking. You can leave it blank or whatever you want to add. It's just for the version controlling system. As you can see, we have version 25. Now, after setup of conversion tracking, we will test it if it's working properly or not. Click preview. And once again, we have our tag assistant open and click connect. Now we will do a test purchase to make sure it's working fine. Oops, it's asking for the password. Let me go back. Close the window and reopen the tag assistant. Okay. Now go to catalog and buy any product to test if and check if it's working properly. Click on buy it now. And here I'll just add all the dummy info. Continue to shipping. Continue to payment. And our test order has been placed. Now let's go back to Tag Assistant. And now you can see that our conversion tracking tag is triggered on our thank you page. So if we go back to the product page, our global Google Analytics tag and conversion linking is firing because we mentioned it to be triggered on all pages. And when we went to thank you page, it triggered all of the tags which we wanted to. Now Google will understand that's if someone bought the product from our website. I'm going to discuss a little advanced topic in which we can set up a conversion tag which will push the value of the product purchased from Shopify to Google AdWords. And for that, we'll first have to go to Google Tag Manager, click on Triggers, and click on New, and create a custom event. So if you guys have watched the second video where we created data layers, and that was the code which we added in our Shopify store where we were pushing the value of our product, which whoever will bought the product, these values will be pushed to Google Tag Manager. And now what we're going to do, we'll set up a custom event and those values will be pushed from Google Tag Manager to Google AdWords conversion tag. Okay, now after setting up a custom event, click on trigger configuration and select on custom event. And here the event name will be same as this one. So that's the event name, WebSense Pro Purchase. That's the code which we added in our Shopify store, if you remember. So we will copy this value and add it here as an event name. Now click on save. And now let's set up a new conversion tag. Measurement, conversions. Select purchase, and here I'll name it purchase new, purchase with total value. And for this one, we'll use value for each conversion as we are pushing the value of the order being placed to Google AdWords from Google Tag Manager. And select every here. Attribution model will be same as the last one which we did, which will be position based. Create and continue. Now select Google Tag Manager from here and copy this conversion ID and conversion lag, conversion tag to our tag in Google Tag Manager, which is here, AdWords conversion track, conversion tag, and rename the conversion ID and conversion label. Make sure you do not do any mistakes while copying and pasting the conversion ID and label, because if you do any mistakes, it won't work properly. So make sure to do this. Now here, as you can see, it's showing up. You might be seeing it blank, but you'll have to select the data layer variable which we created. So you will click on plus icon and select total value data variable, data layer variable, which we created on our previous video. And on triggering, select the custom event which we recently created. So I'll just remove this one. And add custom event here. Now hit save. Hit submit and publish our conversion tracking code. Now let's test it up if it's working or not. Pretty excited, huh? Should be working. Click on preview again. And here's the window. I'll do another test order. Continue to payment. Complete order. And here we go. So that's the value which should show up on our Google Tag Manager conversion tracking code which we created for Google AdWords. Now let's go back to our Tag Assistant, and that's the conversion tag which fired up. And when we click on here, as you can see, we are seeing the value which is here. So whoever will add the order will be able to see the value, which means the code is working completely fine. That's it for this video, guys. Now in next video, we'll be learning how to set up Facebook ad campaign for our Shopify store. And on final video, we'll be learning how to install Facebook Pixel on Shopify and track conversion through Shopify Pixel. So if you want to learn, watch the next video. Till then, have a great day.